Assalamu alaikum. This course is on environmental economics. So I'm going to start with looking at the environmental problems. Well, as you all know, this environmental problem is not something new. We have seen it in our everyday life, and except maybe we are not really concerned about it during the last decades. Nowadays, we have to be concerned with the environmental problems. In fact, awareness on environmental problems has increased significantly in the past decades, both at national and global level. Environmental problem has been taken into consideration in many business decisions and corporate planning. Even governments responding by passing environmental laws and establishing pollution control, as well as monitoring to protect the environment. On the part of the corporate sector, the response is generally complying with regulations, on productions and product design. This is particularly necessary in order to remain competitive in a marketplace where many consumers specifically seek out environmentally responsible producer. On the part of the people or consumers in general, in some countries, in fact, in most countries, they are changing their consumption patterns to incorporate environmental responsibility in their market decisions. For example, consumer preferences change in favor of biodegradable detergents, non-ozone depleting products, and of course, recyclable packaging. So in order to comprehend this changing marketplace, it is necessary to understand the fundamentals of how markets work and the relationship between market activity and nature. We will look into this decision making from the economic point of view, or from the view of economists. So if from the view of economists, economic analysis usually uses models to explain the strategic decision making and economic conditions that define the marketplace. By eliminating unnecessary detail, models allowed economists to test theories about economic relationships and to make predictions about behavioral and institutional reactions to changes in market conditions. So for these reasons, modeling is a fundamental tool in environmental economics. And to understand environmental problems or environmental issues from the economist's point of view, let us begin by looking into the basic fundamental economic models. This model shows how decisions are made in the market, and it is called a circular flow of economic activity. This is the model, actually, or the model which is a basic economic model, which is a two-sector model, the inner flow indicating the real or monetary flow, whereas the outside showing the supply and demands of goods and services, as well as both in the output and factor market. However, this model is not comprehensive. If you look carefully, this model does not show the linkages with the environments. There is no environment element in this particular model. So it is important that we understand the critical relationship between economic activity and nature, and to use that knowledge to make not only better but wiser decisions. So this model is therefore extended to illustrate the linkages between the economic activity and nature. So this is the new models. If you see these models, the extension is on the upper part, the upper part of the models, which indicate the relationship of economic activity with nature, whereby we draw resources from nature, and then this is sold in the factor market, bought by the firms, and then turned into goods and services for consumer to use. And eventually, after productions and consumptions, all this will go back as residual to nature. And some can be recycled, reused, and recovery. So we see that this particular model, which is actually called materials balance models, places the circular flow within a larger or bigger schematic view, showing these very important linkages between economic activity and the natural environment via two important sets, as I mentioned earlier, resources drawn from nature, from the environment, which is natural resources, and the flow of this residual from the economy to the environment, which is the subjects of environmental economics. What is residual? Residuals are pollution remaining in the environment after some process of economic activity. And this residual, as I mentioned earlier, cannot be prevented, but can be delayed through recovery, recycling, and reuse, as we have seen in the inner flows in the balance models. Okay, I think I'm going to stop here. We will continue our lecture again next week. Thank you.